So, who is this book for? Like, who should really be looking at this book? People that are already experienced in it, or is it a good beginner book?
So, I'm going to answer this two different ways. The first way is I want you to know this isn't a boring computer book. This isn't a book where it's like, okay, now press this button, okay, and then do this, and then you do that. It's not boring. It's fun.
It's
It's like you
fun.
said, an easy read. I'm kind of talking in the book like I talk, which I mean, don't the grammar police don't get too offended because I do have publishers that are fixing my words, but I'm trying to make it understandable so that people so people see that, that makes sense. I should try that. And so, by the way, I'm giving that encouragement throughout the book. Try this, do this, and so it's not just about, oh, I don't want to buy a computer book. I'll just figure it out on my own. You're not going to figure it out like this, believe me. And this, for this investment, it's so much better to take this book. And even if you just look at a chapter at a time or pick it up when you need it and want to do something, then that becomes a good reference. But so sorry, that's the first part. It's not boring. Sorry guys, not boring. Second part is who should buy it? Well, if you write notes. If you write notes and you have notes, maybe it's a spiral notebook that you're using, maybe it's the notes on your phone, maybe you're writing all these Word documents full of all this reference material, maybe you have sticky notes all around your computer or stuff on your walls that's helping you remember stuff. Do you write any notes? Because wouldn't it be great to have those notes with you anywhere on your, whether it's on your phone or on your computer, or on your laptop or on your tablet, and also have those notes easily searchable. So you wrote that note 3 months ago or 6 years ago, you can find it. Whereas if that piece of paper, a little harder to find. So that means this could be for someone that works in an office, or this could be for somebody that stays at home and just wants to organize all their recipes. So I even have an example of how to organize your recipes using OneNote. So it's for anybody.
The one thing that I really appreciated about the book, Connie, was that you talked about, because you just talked about take your notes with you everywhere, that in the book, when you're giving examples, you're talking about whether you're on your iPad, on your phone, or on your computer. And it was fun. It's an easy read. It's bite-sized pieces. I think that it would appeal to any type of learner.